Have you ever seen the movie Dirtbag?
No.
No?
No.
Really? Uh-uh. Oh, it's amazing.
What's it about?
It's about a climber, about a guy who literally climbed his whole life. I forget the gentleman's name.
Dirtbag?
He's a famous climber. Fred
oh,
Becky.
I know, yeah, I know who Fred Becky is.
Dirtbag, meaning that, you know, he would just camp out and sleep on people's couches and climb and all across the world, and was meticulous in his recording. It's an amazing documentary.
Yeah.
Even for someone like me who has zero interest in doing that. But he climbed till he died.
Yep,
I mean, he just kept going, and it shows it in the film. You know, you see footage of him when he was younger. Versus, I mean, there he is, like, overnight camping prohibited.
Yep.
Nope, fuck you, I'm sleeping here.
Yeah.
He just slept everywhere. And it just shows, like, how bizarre his obsession with hiking and camping and climbing was. I mean, he just wanted to get out there and climb all these different peaks and all these different mountains and all these different paths, and recorded everything.
Yeah.
Like, super meticulously, had boxes and boxes of notes, and he would go over the notes and show people routes and all the different things that he learned while he was doing it. I mean, he was obsessed. I am just fascinated by people that have a singular obsession like that and carry it for their entire life.
Yeah, I mean, I think climbing, for me, and I personally think climbing is very easy to become obsessed with, because there's so many different facets to experience it in. Like, you can go to the climbing gym and just play around on some plastic holds, or you can work towards climbing something like Mount Everest, and then, like, everything in the middle. And so there's just a lot to do. Like, I just feel like I don't even have, I have, like, a lifetime's worth of things to do in climbing.
Hmm. That makes sense. I mean, watching that guy, watching the Fred Becky movie, Becky, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Watching that movie and seeing his lifelong obsession, seeing other climbers sort of talk about him and the experiences they had with him, and about, like, there's more going on than just climbing, right? There's some sort of strange, it's a chase of a mental state. There seems to be a mental state of people that climb and want to reach the peaks of these things and navigate these difficult routes, that there's some sort of a game going on in your mind, and there's rewards. There's, like, this good feeling that everyone is getting while they're doing this. You're, like, filling yourself up with endorphins when you're accomplishing these things. Is that safe to say?
Yeah, I could agree with that. I mean, I think for me, climbing is my passion, and it is essentially, like, my vehicle for experiencing, like all of the wide spectrum of emotions that we all have. You know, it's my vehicle for exploring fear. It's my vehicle for exploring achievement and success and ego and confidence. And, you know, I think you could really, like, use anything in order to explore those emotions. But everyone, I think, in some way is trying to find what their vehicle is to explore those emotions. And for me, it truly is climbing. Like, up there on El Cap, like, I went through the whole spectrum of emotions the whole day, just up and down in, like, the most extreme ways possible.